As the idea of country living seems to invoke feelings of relaxation away from the hustle and bustle of our lives. Well, Melissa Behan, creator of the popular blog Lulu the Baker, actually lives on a farm in Oregon. Her new book, Farmhouse Weekends, is about simple food for a modern country life. And she's making the most out of all the fun vegetables that are available to us now, including one of my favorite desserts.
Today, we are making a classic carrot cake with cream cheese frosting from my new book, Farmhouse Weekends.
I love carrot cake. It is one of my favorite things. Let us jump right in because all I want to do is talk about cream cheese frosting.
Yes, and we have some and we will get to that. Okay, so we are going to start. One of my favorite things about this cake is that it's an old-fashioned recipe, so it does not need a mixer. You can do it in a mixer if you want, but you don't need to, and we're not going to use one today. So we're going to start by mixing 4 eggs, 2 cups of sugar, and 3/4 cup of oil. And that can be canola oil or vegetable oil, any neutral oil that you like to bake with. And we're just gonna whisk that up.
I love that it's no mix style, because sometimes I don't even like pulling out the whole mixer. It's like, it's my workout for the week.
Yes, and this is such an easy one to do. All right, so that's all we need for that. We're gonna set that aside for a second. And now we're gonna work on our dry ingredients. In here we have 2.5 cups of flour, and it's just all purpose flour. We're gonna add 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. Mm-hmm. We're gonna add 1 teaspoon of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of salt.
And you like to keep your dry ingredient spoon separate from the wet, and so it doesn't make too much of a mess, right?
Right, so for now I'm just gonna stir it with this. And now we can add these dry ingredients to the wet ingredients that we mixed up a minute ago. And you can use a spoon for this part, or you can use a whisk, whatever one you want.
If I had a whisk like yours, I love it. You are inspiring me. I'm gonna go buy a giant whisk this weekend.
Whisks take a lot of that elbow grease that you would need, so it's really nice. And then we're just gonna mix that together until the dry ingredients are just barely mixed in. And then if you feel like your whisk is clogged, you just bang it on the side of the bowl a few times and all of that batter will come right out. And now we've got all of the fun things that go in carrot cake. We've got carrots. This is 2 cups of loosely packed shredded carrots. Now the key is you cannot use the pre-shredded carrots from the store because they're really thick. You need to chop your carrots a little bit first. The longer your pieces of carrot that you put into the food processor, the longer the shreds you'll get. And you don't want big ribbons of carrots in your carrot cake.
That was gonna be my question, is can I buy the pre-shredded stuff at the grocery store?
Yeah, I know, me too. I love shortcuts in the kitchen. We've got our 2 cups of loosely packed shredded carrots. We're gonna add an 8-ounce can of crushed pineapple. You just have to make sure you drain it really well first. Otherwise, all that extra juice, all the extra moisture will make your cake a little bit too wet. And then we've got 1 cup of sweetened shredded coconut flakes and 1 cup of golden carrots. I figured my philosophy with carrot cake is the more the merrier. The more delicious stuff we can get in that carrot cake, the better it's gonna taste. So we're gonna mix that together, and then that goes into a greased 9x13 pan.
Okay.
And it goes into a preheated 350-degree oven for about 40 minutes, 40 to 45. If your oven cooks hot, you can start checking it a little bit early. Everybody knows their oven best.
That's a good point.
I have a cake that's all ready to go, and we are gonna frost it. We're gonna get that cream cheese frosting that you want.
I love it.
All we did for this one was mix a brick of cream cheese, an 8-ounce brick of cream cheese, and 1 stick of butter, which is 1/2 cup of butter, both a little bit softened. And we just beaded those until they were smooth. And then I added 1 pound of powdered sugar, 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and 1 pinch of salt. And just whipped them until they were nice and smooth. And look at that delicious frosting.
Oh my gosh.
And I love cream cheese frosting on chocolate cake. I love it on yellow cake. I love it on sugar cookies. Obviously carrot cake, cinnamon rolls. It's such a good versatile frosting recipe to have in your arsenal.
I love it on cinnamon rolls. I love it on my finger, just licking it out of the bowl. It's just great anywhere. Tell us about your book, Farmhouse Weekends.
Yeah, Well, about 15 years ago, my husband and I were driving around in the country, and we found this beautiful piece of land that was for sale. We dreamed of buying it and putting a farmhouse on it someday, and that land miraculously waited for us to be ready for a few years. And we just love to cook good comfort food, especially seasonal stuff like this carrot cake that really makes use of seasonal produce. So that's what the recipes are all about in Farmhouse Weekends.
I love it. And I love that your carrot cake too, it's not one of those fancy, put it on a cake stand. It's something that's attainable for everyone. And I love it.
How many times can I say I love it? Because I do. I truly do. There is something so comforting, though, about carrot cake. It's not fancy. It's just delish. And Melissa is sharing that recipe with us. Just go to our website and bake it up and share it. If you make it, will you share it on the Instawebs, the New Day Northwest? We're on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. So share it, because sharing is caring, right?